go hard. Nigga, I 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 go hard. Welcome to another week of Pop Radio, iHeartRadio, Spotify Premium, Putting On People Radio. It's your boy Prince of Pain at the House of Pain.
And it's your girl Bree.
Turn up Tuesdays with my girl Bree. Late today, I'm a little bit mad at Bree right now. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to mention her until halftime, you know. But no, Bree's in the building. I got beautiful, lovely baddies of the week. That's in the building, you guys. All the way from the very end, I got Mommy KK. She brought a beautiful, beautiful
photographer.
Here we go again with this bullshit. But she got her hair done up. I definitely complimented on her hair. Bree's in the building. And Deja is also in the building. So make some noise. All these ladies are working. I know Mommy ain't a first time with a Pop Radio. She's been featured on iHeart before. She does booking now. She does other stuff for Pop, you know, when it comes to production. And today she brought me some amazing talent. We're going to shoot them courtesy of Avon Printing. The whites in the building, so make some noise for my wonderful friend. It's not that wonderful, but you know. That track we just played, man, is Beads and Twista. Go Hard. One of my favorite joints, man. I think that's one of Beads' dopest joints. That's his classic right there. Make sure if you have not purchased that joint, it's on iTunes, Tidal, and all that other good stuff. Beads, Twista, Go Hard. We just got back from LA, man. Shout out to Tom Bomb Podcast. Shout out to everybody in the Palaces, Beverly Hills area, to the Cookies Dispensary joint, and Smokey that just took care of us. You know, it was a different experience for me this time. I was last time in LA nominated for a Spoken Word Award. This time it was for a year deal. We were treated like kings up in that motherfucker. I swear to God, you hear me? Hey man, again, salute to the hospitality. I know Cuban Link loved it. We had a fucking rooftop, we had a pool, and when we woke up right out of our bedrooms, you couldn't see nothing but that beautiful atmosphere that California has in the mountains and the ocean and Santa Monica Beach and all that great stuff. So what's going on, we have just expanded, so salute to Putting On People Radio. We are now in LA. Tom Bohm of the Tom Bohm Podcast has opened the doors out there. We have signed into a 1-year deal to run his podcast with us and have it on iHeartRadio and Spotify Premium, Dreezer, and every other application we're on for the next year. So for the next year, I will be traveling. I'll be back doing flyer will be up tomorrow. It's Chicago to LA. I'll be in LA October 3rd. Tom Bohm Podcast, Putting On People Radio. We're going to have a special guest this rip, like we did this month, which was Cuban Link. I don't want to mention who the special guest is yet. We're going to have models. We're going to do baddies of the week. It's going to be poolside, and we're going to get it turned up next month in LA. So anybody from fucking Arizona, Denver, Colorado, Detroit, anybody trying to get your music on iHeartRadio, you're trying to get your stuff on our platform, it's real simple. If it's dope, we're going to respond. But if it's trash or it's not marketable, bro, I'm not going to sis, I'm not going to lie. We can't do it. We're not thirsty. You know what I'm saying? Try back with another joint. That is just that simple. Everything's not for the radio. Right now they got all these stipulations and rules of what they got on. GCI is getting sued. Power 92 is getting sued. Right now they cannot promote no sex. Sex they could. Drugs, violence, and guns. You know what I'm saying? Which is, you know, a freedom of speech. If you can sell it on Netflix, you can sell it on Stars, why can't you, you know, sell it if these kids are packaging or whoever's packaging their pain or whatever and putting it in music instead of going to light nobody up or kill themselves or other people. I think that's still some bullshit. But again, we are on iHeartRadio, we have our own podcast channel, so we play with the fuck we wanna play here, you know what I'm saying? But just make sure it's marketable. Make sure that if we do put it on our platform, it's gonna do well, you know? And it's just that simple. Keep it 3 minutes and under. I don't care if it has cuss words in it. You know, we are an explicit channel. Just keep it 3 minutes and under. Leave a daytime phone number. Send it to popradioworldwide@gmail.com. Make sure you're in tune with the Instagram, Pop Radio Worldwide. Make sure you're in tune with the website, popradioworldwide.com. Make sure you're fucking with us on YouTube, Facebook, all that good shit. Salute to all my people right now watching us on Facebook Live. Bree, anything you want to say, man? I ain't let you say shit yet.
I thought you were mad at me.
Well, I'll get over it. You know what I'm saying? Say what's up to the people on Pop Radio.
What's up, Pop Radio? Y'all see me looking real nice or whatever.
Thank you for trying to look at you today. How was your weekend this weekend? Did you pop out to a couple of events? What was going on this week? Reggae thing or some shit you had going on? What?
Last night,
you sent me a flyer over the
phone. Oh, yeah. I went. They had like a reggaeton night at the Lobo in Cicero, on Sir Mac. They had like a DJ come and I went to dance with my friends.
Okay. Salute to Diamonds Bar. Salute to District Bar. Salute to Debbie from Ocean's Nightclub. Turn up with me Thursday when I go there and rock out with A-Rab, Crescent Records, Queen Keys. And I don't know who else is coming through that joint, but it's Thursday night. It's going to be busting. Fuck with your boy. We're going to take a quick little music break. We're going to come right back. I'm going to get to the mamacitas just in a minute. We ain't going to get right to them yet. I got a little topic I want to kick with y'all about. I'm going to give y'all a couple of artist tips, and then we're going to get to the little baddies of the week. You know what I'm saying? It's your boy, Prince of Pan. We on Pop Radio Worldwide, iHeart Radio, Spotify, Premium. Be right back.
Mama, stop playing making beats again.
Nigga, two-fold a goat, these other niggas basic.
Chicago got them having ass things in the city. Yeah, you know we keep it tight. Yeah, you know we keep it pretty. Garfield is a park where you know we keep it lit. 107.5, got my shit bumping in the city. When I wanna hit the club and really pop out. Me and my girls hitting oceans on what I'm talking about. When I step in the club, you know I need that love. Telling DJ Ferris, gonna turn my shit up.
If you feel me and your women, come walk to this.
We back on Pop Radio Worldwide, iHeartRadio, Spotify Premium. It's Turn Up Tuesdays. The voice pop. It's Bree over here with my phone not on silent and shit. We got baddies of the weekend here. That was Nikki, Nikki Monroe. It's called Chi-Town. I want some feedback, YouTube. I want some feedback, Facebook. I want some feedback, Instagram. It might be that next banger. She was just through here. We just showed her love. She was an artist spotlight. What do you guys think of the joint? I'm going to start with you, Mommy. What you think of that?
It was good.
It's a little bop into that, right?
She
look like Megan a little bit.
She do?
Yeah, she do a little bit. Straight up. Sis Bree, what you think?
I like it. I think she's good.
Okay. It's got a little turn up in it.
She got a little bounce, yeah.
A little bounce.
Like 22.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think she got the right idea with finding like the trend and music.
Okay. You know what, she had a joint before that, it wasn't so up. Example, but we showed it love, but I think this one's better.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Something they play in the club.
Yeah, yeah. I think she gonna nice little video. I think the video dropping soon. So salute Nikki Monroe. We fucking with the joint. The girls are liking it. Keep doing your thing. Salute to Mommy, man. Mommy, I appreciate you, man. You always come through for me. Everybody make some noise. Mommy just did like two videos. One, and she does a lot of other amazing. I'm not the only one. She like pop just be familia, I guess. Because she treats me like family.
That's,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And her resume is like Mike Tyson said. Impeccable. You hear me? Her shit is impeccable and ferocious, you know? But she does a lot of shit, man. I need you to go follow, say it, because you got a fake page out there that was following this one. Say
it right. I just got that fake page taken down. Thank you.
Oh, they hit me early in the morning. I'm like, damn.
I was like mad as fuck about that shit.
How but they even made the text curvy and everything like yours.
Exactly.
I'm like, okay, she got a backup page. You know what I'm saying?
They're thought you had a backup page. Uncensored content. I'm like, what? Where, bitch? Because how you get that shit? You spraying on me in my shower?
Right.
That's sad. People got to do that, though.
Yeah, it's real sad. It's real sad because this is how I feed my son.
But you know what? If you ain't got no haters, you're not popping. You know what I'm saying? I know, so you must be doing something right.
Yeah.
So, Mommy, we're going to get to the people. We're going to tell them some of the other projects you worked on. But Mommy was just in Block's video that just dropped. Everybody go cop that. It's already everywhere on Google Play. Yes. Shit, the shit's on TikTok. You know what I'm saying? Yes. Block's is on motherfucking TikTok. But
that was beautiful too.
We got on the boat. Salute to Red, man. Red took us out through the whole downtown in a little boat.
Riverwalk.
Salute to Queen.
Queen. Yes.
She rocked out the video. Salute to me and her camp went the
hotel.
Me and Bree went like a whole nother day. We did a hotel scene with her. We did I went and took the same boat during the daytime so I get more solo shots.
Yeah.
Because a Jeep didn't come through for me that was supposed to come through.
Let's say her IG is Barbie.doll.queen. Go follow her.
She what is it, baby? Barbie dot
queen.
Okay, dot queen. Barbie.doll.queen. Yeah. She's
go follow her.
Look like she's foreign and all. This one here I got to make. Bree looking a little foreign over here. Where you from, Bree?
I'm from Naperville.
no, like your roots. Since you got some Spanish or something.
I do. I'm white, black, Indian, and Puerto Rican.
Yeah, you're Puerto Rican.
Well, right. Well, yeah, okay. In the house.
Look, every lady that I bring through here, man, sometimes, y'all know I just be, you know, sometimes I'm gone for 2 weeks. And I try to give y'all, not just y'all, but also the ladies, because I've been doing this shit for 3-4 years.
Okay.
I'm the only one that does baddies of the week on iHeartRadio in the Midwest for the last 3-4 years. And I try to make sure that all the girls that are doing videos, the bottle girls, the dancers, that all y'all getting some love too, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Not just the little rappers that think they clouded up, you know what I'm saying? But the girls that actually make our shit look good and that be breaking their neck. That's a profession, man. So the baddies of the week is always there's a house here for y'all. You know what I'm saying? So, Mommy, real quick before I do get to Bree, tell us some of the projects you're working on right now.
I just did a video with Spredo.
Okay.
Wait on it. And then I also have a fashion show with these two are my models.
Beautiful.
They're some of my models. So my clothing line is called Exotic. And it's coming in October 17th in Waukegan. Just follow my page, Mommy KKMAMII, only two I, and then KKKAYKAY. And I'll have all the details on there, and you can buy tickets on there as well.
For the fashion show?
Yeah.
What's the name of the event?
It's Exotic Strength.
Okay. Follow her. She's going to give you all the details. Yeah. All these beautiful ladies going to be there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Mommy, I am going to come back because I do, you know, I not only bring you guys up here and feature you guys, but I like you guys to tell these young girls who's just getting into modeling. Give them some tips. You know what I'm saying? Bree, what side of the town you rep? Naperville, you said?
I'm from Naperville, but I live in Carroll Street.
Carroll Street.
Mm-hmm.
And how long you been in the industry doing baddie work?
I literally just like started because at first I was like shy, so I just got into like photo shoots.
You ain't tricking me. You ain't
really?
Tricking Pop.
No, no.
You ain't tricking me.
No, really, I've been like boring. Shy, like first. So I just got into it maybe like 2 months ago, and then I'm in school, so it gotta like.
What you going to school
work
for?
Out my LPNs right now.
Dope.
So I gotta like work out.
So you just started.
What school?
No, the modeling and the.
Yeah, maybe video. Like 2 months ago. No, okay. Mine. About like 4 months ago.
Okay, anybody inspire you to do it?
No, I'm just like, why not? I got the body, why not?
Beautiful. I see, you know, yeah, just keep the same attitude and around the same beautiful energy. And Mommy gets a lot of work, man. People love her.
Does.
You know, people love her. So as long as you stay around the right people, look like that. You're gonna be all right. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Do you wanna ask Bree anything, Bree?
Oh.
Bree, do you wanna ask Bree something? You know what I'm saying?
Ask each other something.
What was your first, like your first gig or your first photo shoot music video? What like started off? What popped your cherry?
She said 2 months. You already did some videos?
Yeah,
stuff?
Not a video. I have a video coming up. But like photo shoot, this guy was just like, hey, like, can you do my photo shoot? For his like lingerie line. I'm like, okay, like, are you finna pay me? Like, I'm not doing that.
degree, but. And so yeah, I was just like, why not? You know, some, I've always thought about modeling, but like I said, I've never like had like the time or like the courage. So I'm just like, why not?
Nice. I'm glad you got your confidence up and pursued something that you can eat off.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And then you can enjoy it. You like looking pretty, right?
Right.
So why not get paid?
Right, okay.
You know. Deja. Deja vu. Is deja vu?
Deja vu.
Deja vu. She got like a little sister, a little vibe to her. So I cut it to Deja, you know? Deja vu. How long you been modeling, honey?
I started modeling kind of when I was in middle school, so I've been modeling for some years. I only really do like small fashion shows in the city.
Runway and then, stuff?
Like runway shows. I do photo shoots here and there. But really when I started photography in high school, me and my friends were all in the same class and we would model for each other. And I felt like I liked that more than I liked photography. So I pursued it more.
Do you still do photography or no? That was just something that you did for like a class in high school?
Yeah, I did it as a class in high school. I do like it. I still have my camera. Like sometimes my family asks to take pictures. We have events and stuff and I do.
Do you feel like since you started modeling, it boosted your confidence? Like taking pictures and stuff like that and made you more confident?
More confident in like being a photographer or a model?
No, just how you feel about yourself.
I wouldn't say it made me more confident. No, I don't think it made me more confident. I think sometimes it can tear you down because, like, if you feel like you look a certain way and you didn't look a certain way in the shoe, like, you pick at yourself more.
What's up?
I don't think it made me more confident.
I want to say we attribute all you guys. I know how hard. Personally, I'm an artist, and I own a radio station, and I own a recording studio, and I know how hard it is to work, just period. And I know how hard it is sometimes to get you guys up in here. I know how hard it is to get motivated. I know how hard it is for you guys to get ready, to find the right outfits, to find babysitters at times. I get it. You know what I'm saying? That's why I do baddies of the week. Because y'all just as dope as everybody else. I do want to attribute, I want to make some noise for all the beautiful women in the house. So I have right now Tom Bomb Podcast. Tom, get your okay, there you go. So number one, thank you for having myself and Cuban Link in LA this week. Or last week. We will be back down there on the 3rd of October. Do you see the lovely ladies in the building today?
What up?
Hey.
Get in the, put a shirt on.
I'm trying, bro. I'm just out of the shower.
Hey, listen. So I'm getting ready to wrap up this segment. I'm talking to the ladies. And it's the same kind of format, man, I want to bring to LA. I want to make sure that all the girls in LA that are not getting featured, that do have a radio station to come to, sit down, a podcast, do get a proper photo shoot, do get run by 2.7 million followers on iHeart and Spotify and everywhere else, just like an artist, because they work just as hard. You know what I'm saying?
I completely agree, bro. All for women equality. Getting their money off
of us. Exactly. They hustle just as hard as us, you know. So I am going to take a quick little music break. What's the name of the podcast we just dropped for you this week on iHeartRadio?
It's Season 1, Episode 9.
Tom Bomb Podcast, streaming and filming live from L.A. right now on iHeartRadio, Spotify Premium, on the website, Pop Radio Worldwide. Just make sure to go to the Tom Bomb podcast tab, and all his content will be there. Tom, I'm going to get with you soon. I'm going to take me a quick little music break. I'm going to talk to the ladies, man, and I'll get with you later.
Thanks to Music Part 2. Dipset, killer, beat me, Tejo Santana, come on, let's go. Can I get up? Here, everywhere, kick.
swap a dime for a penny.
Support Chris and Pain, man. Be back on Pop Radio Worldwide. I have our radio on Spotify Premium. I'm here with Bree. Bleana, you hear me? Make sure you follow Lil Mama 1200 on IG. Make sure you spam us on Facebook, YouTube, and all that good stuff. It's that time of baddies of the week, and the first runner-up, really my iHeartRadio baddie of the week, is Deja Vu.
I was on point with the last hoe killer. Make sure I got her for a refund. I gave her back to the street. Forever I rip, put the set on the chain. I'm thugging you, I already know how
to count.
Yeah,
you
got money.
We got another
three. Her man, he in pit, it's my teeth. She got a blue chick and a chick with a meat knife. Put a nigga riding in the phone on E-Bill. Figure the nigga COVID-19, so riding the walking, trying to keep the cup. Shake came up like Giannis, I get bigger.
Last but not least,
right now in this truck,
got mommy KK in the field.
Put you in the blender, I can get you slush. I see the comments, but really I'm bothered. I know it's hurting, she salty, I scarred her. Be worried what you lay up and say to these bitches, they can't have a I thought a broke nigga said something. Talking shit, but they still understand me. You gon' trap this bitch up to the fence. Running up, huh? What she say? I thought a pussy hoe said something. Know when I'm talking, you listen. Jealous. Cut her off cause she spoke on the business. Go!
Man, this nigga bad, man. He's so wack. I'll be
That's Money Bag Yo says something. I'm not gonna say nothing negative. I be petty as hell, you know what I'm saying? So I got my baddies in the building. All of them are beautiful. All of them are amazing. I really want to thank y'all again, and I do want to make some. Any lady interested in being one of our baddies of the week again, you ain't got to be no runway model. All you got to do is send us one paragraph to popradioworldwide@gmail.com. Two pictures. The paragraph, I just want to know why you should be an iHeartRadio baddie of the week. Why should I spend my bread, bring you up here, shoot you, and, you know, promote you? Why? Is you a dope karate instructor? Is you a dope dancer? Is you, you know, give me a reason of, you know, why you a baddie of the week. That's all I want. You know what I'm saying? Artists, we are featuring music right now. 3 minutes and under songs, daytime number, popradioworldwide@gmail.com. Let's get to the baddies of the week. Let's start with you, Bree. Who you want to hop at first? Who you want to hop at first?
Deja.
Deja? Okay, let's get it. Let's get it.
Oh, I'm talking?
Yeah, you picked her.
I don't know. So what are we talking about?
I mean, they're beautiful models.
Oh, yeah, you guys
just a little bit. I mean, I do want you guys to tell the girls that are just getting in, give them some tips. You know, mommy, I know you a little so-called little veteran already in the game, even though, you know, that sounds old, but no.
Nah, I was like, you telling my age, hold
on. No, you know, I just know you've been working, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
So I know you got a little, I want everybody up here, even you, sis, even, if, you know, you just getting into it, but you learning the ropes. Any little tips? Mommy KK, let's start down there. Give the ladies in the game that are just getting some young 17-year-old ladies that, look, I want to be a model. I want to get in the industry. Give them 3 tips real quick. All the ladies, I want 3 tips for the young girls getting in the game.
Don't do nothing that you're not comfortable with. Don't be pushed by the industry. Definitely, you are your own brand when you're a model. You're representing you, you know? So, I mean, for me, I manage myself. I do everything myself. So, I don't let nobody push you some type of way because that's just, you could get took by this industry real easily.
Oof.
Real easily. That would be my advice.
That's good.
That's really good. That's 3 tips for me. That was raw truth.
Yeah.
Deja Vu, you got some tips for the ladies?
Yes. Let's see. Know your strengths and weaknesses.
Know your strengths and your weaknesses,
if
and work
you don't
on them,
come
right?
In knowing them, learn them, work on them. That's the way to get better. Definitely network. Always put yourself out there. And thirdly, don't let nobody shame you about whatever it is that you decide to do. Some gigs have to do, and you may not get paid. And people ask you, "Oh, you modeling? You think you're a model? You're not even getting paid."
It took me a long time to start getting a check.
It takes you a while to get to where you want to be. Yeah. Don't let nobody shame you or make you feel like you're
gotta
not
get to
doing
that level first,
you what know? You're trying to do because you're not there yet. Fact.
That's good.
Bree, something tells me that, you know, even though, sis, you just started modeling,
mm-hmm.
like, you know, you got some sense about you. You know, like, maybe you didn't do this, but you might have did some that took some strict skills to maneuver and demonstrate. You know what I'm saying? So give a couple of y'all sisters, man, a couple little tips from yourself.
I would say
maybe some tips that were handed to you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I was told not to be shy and to just go for it. And like she said, don't let nobody tell you that you can't do it, because you can't. You can do anything that you like put your mind to. That's really it. Shit. Have fun.
Have fun.
Life is short.
I'm gonna start down there, then I'm gonna let Bree let you get at y'all for a minute. Fun facts. Mommy, KK, give me a fun fact about you.
Ay, Dios.
Que te gustan los tacos. You like tacos where you go to sleep with one sock. Give us a fun fact.
Ew, I can't sleep with socks.
I can't either.
Really?
Yeah.
You're weird.
Yeah, no, I can't.
I can't do that.
Give me a fun fact.
Girl,
baby.
That'd be cool. Why? Dude, what time I can eat with socks? People that sleep with socks. I have seven siblings.
Middle child. You're in the middle?
Yeah.
Okay. Deja vu. Give me a fun fact about you.
Me and my dad have the same birthday.
Okay.
That's cool.
Okay.
My grandma,
my
aunt.
I'm ready for
Bree's
fun fact.
Fun fact.
Tell me you like to ride electrical bulls or some shit.
She looks like her pants are like...
Yes. But, oh, we can...
I like to have fun. Like, I'm crazy.
You're crazy?
Are you toxic? Are you toxic?
A little bit.
Oh, shit.
Are you toxic or are you just addictive?
Both.
She said toxic. She said toxic a little bit.
No, so. I'm not toxic.
You said a little bit.
I can get back.
Yeah.
I just know what I want, and I get it.
Get that shit. Bree, go ahead. I asked them, what did I just ask them? A fun fact. Now you going.
Where do you guys see yourself, like, working, or what are, like, goals you guys want to reach? Where do you see yourself in, like, the next 5 years? Like, what do you want to accomplish, you know?
5 years.
Where do you see yourself? Or if you've already... reach what you want.
I kind of know Mommy can't live this, so I want to see what she says in 5 years.
I know. Yeah. So
Mommy, congratulations. You've been working hard the last 2 years, honey.
You have. Yeah, and that's really exactly
congratulations,
what I want to get to. Thank you, Bobby. I want to get to a place where I'm not working so hard because I understand right now is the grind. I'm good with it, you know, at this place in my life. But in 5 years, I'll be 30. 31. So I definitely want to be set, not working so hard, home with my baby, raising him. And even now, I'm blessed because being a model, I get to really raise my son for the most part. I don't have to work 9 to 5. Right. And I push my schedule as much as I can to like accommodate him. But I definitely want to get to a place where it's like I just work on the weekends, and Monday through Friday I could be, you know, dropping him off, picking him up, giving him everything I can.
So that's your goal?
That's my goal. It's all about my body.
What about you, Bree?
My goal, 5 years.
Where you're going to school?
I want to be like, well, I don't have to work. Like when my little business is or whatever, I want to be like,
can I cut you off?
Yeah.
Even bosses.
Yeah, but
when you got a business, you work more.
Not like a 9 to 5. Like I would.
Oh, I never did that.
I mean, I know it's work. Okay. Like, I don't know. I just
want to
like wake up in my sleep and you got a deposit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you get there. You're gonna be like, damn, is it worth it? You gonna look at the deposit in a year, 2 years from now? You gonna look at the deposit? Man, do I want to do this shit? I promise.
Yeah.
You hear me?
What about you, Deja? Where do you see yourself? What are your goals? Where do you want to be? What you working for?
I want to accomplish generational wealth. Like, I want to have wealth for myself and my family. I don't really want, like, I want to be able to take trips and relax.
Live comfortably.
Yeah, like, I want to live more than comfortable.
Everybody wants that.
Yeah.
I do.
I want to go to Mommy KK.
Yeah.
This industry that you are in, is there, I know the, you know what I noticed about the females, and I wish the brothers, talk to me right now. I be trying to, man, look, my show's about awareness, empowerment, educational culture. I'm all about, I did 20 years. That ain't no secret. Mommy know it. The whole city of Chicago, I was locked up 20 years. Yep. I've been home not even a decade yet, and I've accomplished a lot. I be trying to push positivity, prosperity, moves, and money. That's it. If you ain't talking that, I'll holler at you. You know what I'm saying? I try to big up and give a shout out to the next empowering, encouraging brother. Yeah. I'll even tell the brother, you look good, bro. I like that jacket. No homo. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing wrong with picking up the next brother because there's a lot of hate in the city of Chicago. We too talented. I promise. Get off the plane in LA. Get off the plane in Tennessee, Nebraska, New Jersey. You the shit if you got a little swag. If you got some sauce, they love Chicago motherfuckers everywhere. You hear me? Just know how to work your shit. Don't hate on the next one. Don't shit on nobody to get up. You ain't got this shit on nobody. But back to my point. Mommy, I've noticed that these sisters and just in general always pick up the next sister. Even in the industry, I've been noticing. And I love it. I'd be like, man, I wish you brothers was more like that. If you could pick up anybody in the city of Chicago right now that you look up to as a model and you'd be like, okay, I like the way she moving, I big her up. Who could you big up right now, baby?
If I could, like, you're asking me somebody that I'm looking up.
It don't even gotta be Chicago, actually. I'll let you go nationwide. Is there a model, a vixen, or something that, you know, she inspires you? You know, that you make sure that every day you go to her page for a little bit of motivation and to see how maybe she doing it this way. I'm a study. I play chess. I study rappers. I study Joe Buttons. I study everything if I want to be a better me. You know what I'm saying? And that's just real life. And I big up everybody. Joe Buttons. I big up Nori. I big up DJ EFN. Fuck you, DJ Academics. But I big up anybody who's doing some positive shit for the culture. You know what I'm saying? He's the one that just feeds off. He's a culture vulture. He feeds off of all the... He'll cause all the bullshit in Chicago. Talk about Reese. Talk about... And ain't even from Chicago.
He just posted about...
He's Tekashi 6ix9ine's boy. You know what I'm saying? Yes, you know, but he ain't even, and he'll go tell something.
Yeah.
You feel quick. You feel me? But I'm not with none of that. But fuck you, Academics. He's a little weak, nigga. But I big up the real motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? Anybody who's using their platform to do positive shit instead of tear down our culture, instead of trying to promote snitches, instead of, you know, trying to tear down, you know, promote, like, violence, and instead of empowering our kid, Dirk and all of them on some positive shit. You know what I'm saying?
I was just gonna say, like,
you know,
I
everybody
watch.
Trying to, you know, do get money, empower our city. You know what I'm saying? Look, it should, for me, on some real shit, I fuck with a lot of rappers, and I respect a lot of rappers. But to me, it's Chicago versus everybody in my heart. You know what I'm saying? And I'll give you respect when I go everywhere. I don't disrespect nobody. But it's that's how I feel. You know, we're gonna take a little quick music break. I'm gonna play right now some Hypno Carlito, Lil Durk, Ain't Right. I'll be right back.
Man, this is real lifestyle.
Hit the radio, iHeartRadio, Spotify.
Fuck looking like a nigga, we really have a shit, you dig?
Oh,
man. Sink into this money, man. Scrap me shit.
It's your girl, Bree, with Pop Radio. Spotify Premium, iHeartRadio, all that. It's Turn Up Tuesday over here. And right before we had our music break, we were just talking to the beautiful ladies, asking them where they see themselves in 5 years, their goals, tips for models, younger models.
We got beautiful ones.
Beautiful. Dang. We got Mommy and Bree.
And Deja Vu just left. We're going to tell you where to follow all the sauce in a minute. You know what I'm saying?
Yep. So it's Turn Up Tuesday, but I'm going to ask y'all for a freaky fun fact for everybody on your Instagram following me.
Freaky
watching.
Fun fact, gentlemen. Look, pay
something
attention.
Something they
want to know. Right now. Pay attention, y'all. Freaky fun fact time. It's Saturday. Saturday, we didn't do a show, actually. We didn't do Sexy Saturdays, but we did more than sexy up here today.
It's very sexy.
You know what I'm saying? Who you asking first, man? Because I'm interested. I'm interested in the freaky fun fact.
Mommy
and KK. Mommy and KK.
Ideal.
Give us a freaky fun fact.
I don't know what I even
You know, it's a freaky little fun fact. I'm not saying get okay, nasty and dirty.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Freaky fun fact about yourself.
Real subtle. Well, I like to twerk my butt cheeks when I'm cuddling, you know, when okay. I'm like, laying on top. Like,
oh.
Twerk my butt cheek.
So, okay.
Like, left cheek, right.
Listen,
left
y'all.
Cheek, right.
You heard it right here first. Left cheek, right cheek. She like to, when she's cuddling, twerk her butt cheeks.
Like,
that's kind of cute.
When you're spooning?
That's
like,
kinda,
yeah, even that. Or, like, when you're, like, you know, just laying on top. You know what I mean?
Me too. Okay, that was cute and cuddly. You know what I'm saying?
You're cute and cuddly.
Yeah,
no,
she is.
No, you mean
I'm a cuddly.
Bree, you got a freaky fun fact.
Oh, this one's gonna be good. I could just feel her.
I got a question for you.
I know. Next.
What's your zodiac sign?
I'm an Aries.
So what is that? February?
April.
Yeah. What you got for us, Bree?
Freaky
fun fact. Tell your fans, the upcoming fans, everybody who's gonna come follow you on IG and show you some love or some spam. Tell them a little freaky fun fact about yourself. You don't like your toes played with, you like them played
not,
with.
I
you like when they whisper in your ear, I'll be back.
Yeah, I just recently found out I like that. Like, if somebody, okay, yeah, if somebody, like, whisper in my ear, like,
thin
my earlobe.
Hey, little mama, let me whisper
in your ear. Okay. I would say that.
So,
yeah.
she likes the dog, the deep voice. So, okay. I'm going to ask y'all a question now.
Yeah, okay.
I think I'm going to start getting a So, you help me, though.
Come on, Pop.
It took like 3 weeks. Oh, no, I'm asking this stuff. You heard? So, Bree, freakiest place you ever dig
that's
at.
A good one.
You know what I'm saying?
At the beach.
At the beach?
Yeah.
Ooh, sand in the coochie. Ooh.
No, girl. Oh my god, yeah, I was just about to say me too. Like, in my car just opened up.
Yeah.
So, Mommy KK, I think I'll ask you a different one than I can ask her the same. Because she said we'd have me too. So, okay. Are you a lights on or lights off kind of person?
Oh, it don't matter.
Don't matter?
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I do want to thank you guys today for coming, being beautiful, showing number love. Mommy KK, use the platform right now on iHeart, Spotify. Give some shout outs. Give your social media where they can go and show you love. Anything you got coming up, drop it now, baby.
Okay, definitely go follow me, Mommy KK, MammiKKay. Again, I have my fashion show coming up, my first fashion line, my baby. I'm so excited
about it. God bless you. Congratulations.
Yes,
you know what? Make some love. It's hard. It's hard in this business. You know what? When you run your own business, when you do your own event, everybody want you to support them. Want to get some free tickets, but won't support you when you do something.
Five.
You know what I'm saying?
Five.
I try to support everybody. I put my own bread. I help a friend when they need it. I be cash-apping motherfuckers when they need it. You know what I'm saying? And you know, support my sister, man. I didn't even know it was your. I thought you were doing, you know, another event for somebody else. Well, congratulations.
For
putting your own shit together. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It takes hard work, dedication, commitment, your own money, and stuff that a lot of these broke.
Traveling and shipping and getting all the girls together.
Yes.
She knows I've been. Getting all these girls to rehearsals. I had my baby at rehearsals.
Ooh, you know what I seen you do the other day?
Yeah.
Ooh, and I thought it was. I mean, I'm not, you know, don't let me blow your head up or nothing.
I do.
I seen you in some choreography dancing.
Uh-huh.
That's
dope.
Yes.
That's dope. That was
not just, you know, not just twerking or, you know, TikTok. I seen you, you know.
I love to dance. That's my little secret. So actually, in high school, I was a dancer. I used to dance in high school, and all when I was a little girl, I took dance classes. And I also used to write music, and I sing too. But that's all secrets that I just, you know, little bit by little.
I'm going to say it right here. You're going to see her within 14 months.
You're well rounded.
Either on a verse or a hook. I guarantee. Watch, it's coming, y'all. I promise you this. I've been told her.
I'm hitting the studio this weekend.
See what I'm saying? Before you do send your shout outs and, you know, attributions and big ups and all that, Who's your favorite, like, only one? Like, your favorite, dead or alive, too.
Okay.
Your favorite, like, female inspirational artist. It doesn't have to be a rapper, just an artist, you know?
Okay. Well, I mean, of course, J-Lo. I grew up on J-Lo. She's so multi-talented. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And she doesn't just stick to one lane.
What did you feel about Selena?
Oh, I love Selena. She was taken from us too soon. And even J-Lo, I was watching a documentary. She said, like, that role that she played for Selena taught her a lot. Because she sat there and watched videos of Selena and watched how she moved and hung out with her family.
It must have been emotional. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
To play. And then even think about not only playing like such a strong figure to her country, but like even thinking, how about if my life was taken away tomorrow?
I know.
You know what I'm saying? By a person that I let close
a hater.
To. You know her story, baby?
Yeah.
A hater.
Yeah.
Her manager or some shit killed her. Because she was hating. You know what I'm saying?
Why?
Yeah.
Story, yeah.
Huh?
Why?
You didn't know about Selena's story?
Well, I always see the pictures of the little old Mexican lady.
You know what?
Yeah.
Sarah,
and then they're
time.
Like, don't trust nobody.
Yeah. On your off time, you should watch the Selena movie.
Well, I seen like clips of like her J-Lo advertising, and like she looked like, I felt like they looked like
J-Lo did a
her
good
dad.
Job. She did a good
yeah.
job.
She
did a good
I didn't see
role.
It.
She put her heart into that role. She really did.
I'm glad her family approved.
Yeah, her dad. Her dad didn't want her at first because she's not Mexicana, she's Boricua.
She killed it.
And he even said in the documentary, he was like, but man, the way her passion, you know, she killed that shit, yeah.
Mommy, KK, give us some shout outs tonight. Number one, your son, because
Number one, my Bobby Chulo, my LJ, who was so hard to leave him. It's always so hard to leave him. Today, I can't wait to get home to him. and shout out to number one, and then Tyler Pepper. We have a video coming out soon too. He actually is.
What's the name of the song?
Regardless.
Make sure you look out for Tyler.
Tyler Pepper.
Tyler Pepper.
Yeah.
Regardless. Mommy KK in the video.
Whatever.
Anybody else, Mommy, you want to send some shout outs to?
Everybody, all my models, Deja Vu. Rhea here.
Rock, keep rocking with baby KK. I mean, yeah, mommy KK is the shit. You feel me?
Okay.
Bree, anybody you wanna send, you know, you might just wanna throw some bows for all I know. You feel me? But
no.
Anybody you wanna shout out tonight?
No, my family, my mama, baby, my dad.
Okay. Tell everybody, man, where they can follow you at and stuff.
Oh, you guys can follow me on Instagram at @AYO_Bria_bad. That's AYOO.
That's a strong name. You. That's a strong. That's some strong underscores
it's
right there.
It's AYOO_BREA_BHADD. AYO Bria Bad.
Many blessings to both of y'all ladies. Brianna over here of Pop Radio and putting on people. Anybody, your man, your other thing, your side thing, anybody you want to send special salutes to tonight?
Well, I guess I will shout out my boyfriend, even though he's on my nerves right now. Cause
big shock.
Whatever. I guess I have to shout him out because he be taking me to and from everywhere I need to go. Like, I told him when he was coming to pick me up, I was
stop
like...
Stop complaining. I just seen him take you to like 4 or 5 dope places and you had like a bomb on the food in your snaps. Bro, pipe it down. Okay, salute to your boyfriend. Anybody else you want to send salute to?
About to Pop, of course. Aww.
Well, anybody else you want to send salute to?
My little sisters, because they always watch me. They watch everything I do. They're looking up to me. And shout out.
What are we looking for here at the station?
We're looking for bad bitches for Sexy Saturdays.
I'm open.
We need baddies of the week, you know?
Yes.
And, you know, artists. And just, like, anything cool, you know?
Right.
If there's something that's eye-catching, worth our time, you know? Something different.
Yes, if you could like throw like 20 pins in the air at one time, if you are a juka, if you are a comedian, if you have talent in Chicago, our city is full of talent. If you are in the surrounding Midwest states and ain't nobody supporting you, get with me, you know, we'll find time. If you got something extravagant, extraordinary, We gonna fuck with you. Just hit the email, popradioworldwide@gmail.com. Leave a daytime phone number. Leave a link to your social media, your website, and why we should contact you back. I do want to send some salutes out to Los Angeles again and Tom for opening the doors, and that was dope. Salute to Cuban Link for taking the ride. Salute to Big Anthony, who jumped on the plane and did the security detail. Salute to the White Avon that's in the building today doing all the photography. Salute to Cannon Montana. It's been another week of Pop Radio Worldwide. I already did.
I done did a lot, you ain't did shit at all. Whipping up a pop, show you how to get it off.